It's Thursday.
It is Thursday. Refresh. There we go.
Oh, hello.
We're there.
Cool. We're going to just give a few minutes for people to get on board.
You tell them about all of the coming shenanigans.
Mm-hmm. We have our first Zoom class.
I saw that. I'm excited about that.
All right, so we're going to just give a few minutes. What time is it? Is it just...
It is 1:01.
1:01. All right, so look, we're pretty much starting on time. Aren't you excited about our happy hour?
I am. We have pulled some fun fabrics and the new shenanigans. Those are going to be fun.
Yes. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to chore. Can you stay right here?
I can.
Guys, hey guys, I'm on a tour. I'm going to take you on a quick tour. Hold on. We're going to run over here. I just want to run over here. The reason why, because we're setting up for our happy hour. We want to be ready for 5 o'clock. Don't forget, tomorrow at 12, we have our blowout sale. That's going to be all the boats we're going to be showing you. It's going to be special buys. But I want to give you just a preview of what we're doing for our happy hour today. Please take a note. Tomorrow's shopping spree will be at 4 o'clock, not 3 o'clock, okay? But look at this. What we have done is we've grabbed some fabrics, ladies. So I want to very quickly go over these fabrics with you. Hi, we're going to have fabrics. This is just a little bit of an array of fabrics that we have pulled for happy hour. We're going to have these lamps on special, guys. Still, we have about 4 of those to sell. This, I guarantee you, those are going to be buy one, get one free on those checks. Those back, there is an assortment of Christmas fabrics, but they're not Christmas. They are winter themed, and they're going to be buy one, get one free. Okay, so buy one, get one free. I want to stack some more on that before 5. The back row is going to be buy one, get one free. These two rows here, the first, that one there, the second, and the third one is going to be buy one, get one half. We got to discuss this one, but that's going to be a good deal on those as well. Guys, we're going to have some fat quarters that you're going to be able to special purchase as well. We have some more that back there in the back. Those are going to be the, the fruits, and they're going to be on special. So just want to give you a heads up so that you can share that with friends and tell them what's going on. Today we're going to be working with the Tajima machine, which is a Juki product. It's a multi-needle machine, and it's an 8-thread model. And 8 threads is all you need, okay? But what I want to show you guys is I'm going to move this over here, and you know, Jess is here with me to help, so she's going to be helping me monitor, so you can throw questions at me.
Oh,
yeah. But with 8 threads, it is made to sew embroidery, monograms, backs of jackets, hats, caps, anything that you can put in a hoop, you can stitch. What's nice about a multi-needle machine, not only that it has colors,
yes,
and you can set your machine up to the color palette that you want, and you don't have to babysit the machine and thread it every time that you need to change a color. So it would just stitch it all one swoop. And you can stitch backs of jackets. You can stitch hat hoops and stuff like that. So you will get 2 small hoops with the purchase of the machine, all the tools you need. You also get 2 of the big hoops for the machine so that you can do back of jackets in front of shirts. Mm. You will also receive 2 cap frames. Most of the industry out there, when you get a cap frame, you're going to only get 1 cap frame. So you got to spend $300 to do another hat. What I love about this is that I can have a hat hooped,
yeah,
or capped, and then stitch one so I can rotate and do 12 hats really quickly instead of having to do one at a time per se. So it's going to come with your 2 cap frames as well. It also has the driver to work with the cap frame. And the driver is just a simple cylinder that allows you to put a cap on. It pops on, right?
That was easy.
It's easy. And it allows it to go back and forth on a cylinder.
Okay.
Okay? Where if you're doing it on a flat machine, a machine that's a basic machine, you would have to undo the buckle.
Yeah.
You would have to use sticky stabilizer and try to put this round cap in a flat surface where you're going to get divots and buckles and stuff and puckers. So this will give you the capability to do a cap
perfectly.
You can do the side of the cap. You can do the back of the cap. Okay? So that's why you want to do, and most people, a lot of people will buy just this machine just to do caps. So all that they're doing is just
hats. Are a big business.
This is something I did a long time ago. Isn't that kind of cute?
That is cute.
And that right there is just simply a gecko, right? And you can do it all in the front of the cap.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, let's talk about how you set the machine up. Okay? When you go to your machine, first thing you're going to pull the threads that you want to do on the logo, or if you're doing a monogram, you're going to pull that. And you're going to tell the machine, by the way, when you go over here, let's go to home. Can you see the screen?
Yes.
You can find, you can, because it does come with software to create your own embroidery design. So what you do is you take your software package that's in the box.
Yes.
Put it on your computer. You have a word processor, basically. Think of that as a word program. But you'll be able to import different formats of other factories or manufacturers, place it in there, size it, create what you want, put it on a USB, stick it in the machine, and you would just go to your USB function, pull that up, and you can pull up an embroidery design. What's really cool about the Tajima machine, if you go into a design that's not stitchable because it's a hat, the machine won't allow you to do it.
Okay. So yeah. It does have its own safeguards.
It has a safeguard, yes. So you pick your design and you choose it. It brings it in. You would then tell the machine what colors you want. Now, the machine is going to do, it's an 8-color machine.
Yes.
So it automatically goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yes.
If you want to change or interrupt the sequence of what is preset, you have your color palette right here, like a little paint. So if I wanted my first color, which is Blinken, do you see the Blinken?
I do.
On the screen?
We do.
Fabulous. So it's Blinken. So if I wanted to change that color to 8, I can change it to 8. When I want to do my next color, I go to 2. It blinks that little piece there. I can change that to 7, right? I can go to my next color. I can change that to 6 or 1, but I'm going the opposite direction, okay?
Yeah.
I'm going to change that to 5. I'm going to change that to 4. I'm just going through my color sequence, you see?
So 3's next.
And then I'm going to change that to 2. And then I'm going to change that to 8. And then I'm going to change that. I'm going to find something I like. I'm going to do that on the yellow. I'm going to do that to color number 5. And I can just hit set. Once you tell the machine what hoop you're working with, that protects you from not doing a design that's too big.
Okay.
So I told it I'm doing a cap frame. If I want to do a pocket, I can tell I'm doing a pocket. Because there's pocket frames you can buy.
I hadn't thought about a pocket. That's kind of
monogram
neat.
Pockets. I walk around sometimes with monogram.
Oh, I was thinking pant pocket.
Or pants, back of a pair of pants you can monogram. If you want to, look, there's a frame for everything that you ever want to do, okay? So I can do a pocket, I can do a sock, I can do a shoe. You know those Ogg boots?
Yeah.
You can monogram those boots. You can monogram a cowboy boot.
Ideas.
You can do round frames. You can do a magnetic frame. Magnetic frames are frames where you don't have to take your inner hoop and pop it into the outer hoop.
Mm.
So you can just have a magnetic, a frame that's magnetic, and then pop it in place. Some people don't like the hoop because they don't like to push down.
Yeah.
They can easily just, and then what's nice about a magnetic frame is that you can just pop it where you want it.
Yeah.
And move it, maneuver it. You can also use, you might have seen me in the past put sticky stabilizer in this frame.
I do remember that, yes. Mm-hmm.
Well, this frame has a little bit of a shelf to it, see?
Yeah.
There is frames that are also sticky frames. They're just a simple flat frame with an opening. You just stick your sticky on the back of it. It's flat.
Hmm.
So it doesn't give you a ditch right here. Okay?
So basically, there's a frame for how you want to embroider.
Yeah, if you're a particular type of embroiderer, if you don't like to hoop, if you like magnet hoops, if you want to stick stuff, you have those kind of things. But hoops are sizable, so there's different sizes for each one. We have it all on our website. So if you have a Tajima machine, you're able to purchase those a la carte.
Yes.
Once you've told the machine what hoop you want, right, you just simply hit set, okay? And it's going to tell you that it's going to move the frame. So you just let the machine, oh, I got to take this off. Sorry, my bad. I'm just going to take my cap hoop off because I forgot. Okay, I'll take that off. It's going to recognize the frame. What it's doing is knowing that you're using a cap frame.
Yeah.
So it's, I'm trying to think of the word. I lost my word. But it is consolidating the machine to use this cap.
Okay.
Okay? If you're using something different, it'd do the same thing with a different frame.
Yeah.
Okay? The most important thing is when you're hooping a cap, right?
Mm-hmm.
I want you to move closer to me. This mechanism, this driver is a cap driver, okay? So what it's made for is that it clamps onto a table.
Okay.
All right? So this clamps on. So this is your hooping station for your cap. A lot of times I prefer the cap frame being higher up so that I can hoop and see things closer to me than bending over. So place this wherever you need to place it.
Yes.
You just need to have a lip to go underneath here. You take your cap frame. Remember, you're going to have two of these. So you can do one hoop, one cap, sew it while the other one is hooping.
Yeah.
You're going to take your tearaway stabilizer.
Okay.
You're going to place your tearaway stabilizer in the cap frame. You're going to take your cap. And then some people, they unbuckle or unvelcro the buckle.
Mm.
If you want more room to wiggle onto the cap frame, then unbuckle it.
Yeah. Now you've got the that folded in a couple of layers. Does it need that much?
I have two. Normally I use two layers. This is pretty thin, so I'm using four because I have an unconstructed cap.
Okay.
An unconstructed cap is just fabric.
Yeah. Okay.
So I prefer, again, ladies, if you know me, I prefer to over-stabilize than under, because under-stabilizing, you get puckers.
Yeah.
Or you get a flaw, and you can't correct it. Putting a couple layers of stabilizer in there, it makes life a lot easier. You'll also be able to stitch trucker hats, any hat you want. This one has buckram in it. Buckram is the stabilizer that you see in here.
Yeah.
Okay? It's a constructed hat.
Yeah, it holds its shape better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some people prefer this. I still prefer to use a stabilizer in the back of the buckram.
Just to be entirely sure.
Just to be safe and also to be nice, to make it look pretty. What you're going to do, ladies, is you're going to, this is how your hat comes to you when you purchase it, right?
Yes.
So you have a sweatband. You're going to take your sweatband and pull it towards the brim, like so.
Okay.
This sweatband goes underneath this ridge here.
Okay.
Okay? So what I'm going to do is take my sweatband. My stabilizer is underneath that metal bridge as well. I'm going to slide my cap onto the cylinder. And on the cap frame, I'm gonna stay right there. On the cap frame, there's a red line right here.
Yes.
That red line I want to follow with the stitching line, the center line of my cap.
Okay. So that one there.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to match that so that when I have this on my cylinder, right?
Yeah.
That is going to be the centering point so that I don't have to do a lot of wiggle room.
Mm.
The more time you prep properly,
yeah,
the less wiggle room you have to worry about. The way this is going to work is that I'm going to put the cap in here. This ridge, or this little piece that you see that goes around like this, right?
Yes.
This is going to go between the brim and the cap itself, right in that ditch.
Okay.
Right in here.
Okay.
Okay? That's going to hold the brim away from the machinery. It's going to also keep it where it needs to be solid. You see the little teeth right here?
Yes.
Those little teeth are going to keep everything in order. You're going to then take this little thing clamps like so, and you push this down, and that's going to keep my hat all in place. That's what I'm going to be doing over here.
Okay.
If you need lessons with hooping caps, I do offer it. I charge $75 if I come out to the home in Richmond.
Mm-hmm.
If you come to the store, it's going to be $75 as well.
Mm.
Okay? But if you, what you do is you set your appointment, the capping of this is the same on any multi-needle. So if you have a different brand, you just need to let me know.
Yeah.
And we can do a personal class. You pay Fabric Cut $75. If you have a couple of friends, maybe I'll give a discount if you want to come in together with two of you guys or three of you guys, all right, that you can get a little discount on that, okay? But individual, it's $75.
Yeah.
So we can do it. It is a all commercial machines capped the same way.
Oh, that's got some good weight to it, too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It looks like it doesn't, but it does.
Yeah. Also, too, when this unit goes onto the machine, it has a stabilizing bar right here.
Yes.
And most machines do not have a stabilizing bar. So when you're embroidering your cap, your frame is bouncing up and down. So you might get off kilter with registration. So let's say you had an apple and you had a straight stitch around the apple. Mm-hmm. Right. Some machines will bounce so much that the straight stitch will be skewed away from the apple. This is a much stronger, it's a commercial grade product.
Yeah.
So it has a stabilizer that allows you to keep that frame nice and taut so it's always going to be nice and pretty. Back to the capping of the hoop, of the cap. What you're going to do is you're just going to smooth out the sweat band, opening it up and going right to laying it flat so it's around the cylinder of the frame, right? Mm-hmm. You're going to bring this up. It's going to lay right in the between the brim and the hat itself. I'm taking my little piece over here, that little spring. Remember that little spring I showed you guys?
Yeah, the belt buckle almost.
Yep. Think of that as a belt buckle. I'm putting that in place. And I'm smoothing out my hat, you see?
Yeah.
Now, you might have to come over just to see how I'm smoothing this out.
Okay.
So you're going to smooth this out, see?
Mm.
Okay. Clamp that down. I want to get this right in the middle. I want the teeth to go right in that stitching, that where the,
that groove, yeah.
Mm-hmm. That keeps everything nice and pretty. You're going to then straighten out the wrinkles. You have these little clips that come with the machine or the cap hoop. There's a spot that you're going to clamp that down.
Okay.
Okay. And then you're going to pull and smooth this out. Smooth, right?
Yes.
Pop this off of the cylinder. This is just like that on the machine.
Okay.
That driver, the cap driver, is a three-part piece. You got the cap driver for the machine, you have your hooping station, and you have the cap hoop itself.
Okay.
You're going to place this into the cap hoop. See how I'm just turning this sideways so I can get it underneath my needle heads?
Yes.
And you see that little cross? You see that, right?
Yes.
Place it onto the machine. And it fits in like a puzzle. I'm going to hit return. And what I want to do is I want to move my cap and the crosshairs in the center. You see?
Yeah.
Got me? That's my center point of my cap. I'm going to hit set. I'm going to trace. And it says it's too large.
Okay.
So I'm going to hit reset. I'm going to find a design that is going to probably be usable, okay?
Okay.
I did not go to my software program. Guys, you know how I am. I just kind of did this on a whim. I'm going to go back to my USB. I'm going to look for a smaller design. I'm going to choose a strawberry.
That looks cute.
I'm going to tell it that I'm working with red, so I'm going to do number 7. That's my top of my cap. That is green. That's number 6. How many people are watching?
We've got 4.
Fabulous. We have number 8, so I'm going to do that one, and then I'm going to hit set. I've already told it that I'm using the cap ring. I'm going to flip my strawberry upside down. You know why?
Because her hat's upside down.
Hello. And then I'm going to wiggle, and I'm going to trace. And it is, I haven't adjusted my cap frame. So I might not stitch today.
Okay.
Okay. Only reason, because not to get into a lot of craziness. But this right here needs to be adjusted just a little bit. There's 4 screws that I have to do.
Okay.
Okay. But once I do that adjustment and I go to my tracing, it will allow me to do an embroidered hat. It's just that I don't want to take too much time on a mechanical thing.
Yeah.
But that's just that you just got to, once you adjust this to the, because this is brand new out of the box.
Yeah. We got this in, what, a week or two ago?
Yeah. So once you adjust these little set screws back here, it balances this to the making of the movement.
Yeah.
It's an X and a Y axis.
Mm.
And you just got to, once it's balanced, you do a trace, it works. Okay? But that is your, that's how you would actually do a cap frame. But it's all about doing the hooping, making sure your stabilizer is in place.
Yes.
Okay? And also, the machine is not going to allow you to do an 8x8 embroidery design on a hat. It's going to tell you that the design is too big. So only thing you do, once you balance out your cap frame, you can hoop for days and stitch. When you are going back to sewing on or embroidering on the machine as standard, right?
Mm-hmm.
I ain't going to show you that. Let me just turn the machine back on. Give me 1 minute. While that's working, while that's opening
thinking.
Up, you're going to unscrew these. This is your cap driver.
Okay.
You have this one and this one. There is 2 down here that you're going to loosen up. Password. This comes off like so. You don't have to remove
that bar,
the bars for your standard flat embroidery.
Okay.
All machines out there, you have to remove these bars. You have another driver. And then you have to, when you finish doing caps, you have to put the other bar, this frame back on. There's a different frame.
Mm.
This machine allows us to take our standard frame, keep it on the machine, place this on, so that you don't have to do any work.
So it attaches itself to the original frame. That's neat.
Mm-hmm. So
that's
then you
handy.
Just screw this back in, screw this back in.
Yeah.
And what you do then, you can do, like, if you had to do like 3 or 4 ball caps, it's not like a lot of disassembling.
Yeah.
You just screw this back on.
I'll be right back.
You do your hat. When you're finished with your hat, you take it back off the machine. And then you can just come to your standard hoop.
And just pop it right in.
Pop it right in.
Oh, I like that.
Mm-hmm. So it keeps me from having to do a lot of thinking, a lot of work. And only thing I do is go to where it shows me my cap and tell it that I'm working with a tube instead of the hat frame. And that is all she writes.
I like the ease of that.
Mm-hmm. So that is that. Now next week I'll probably just do a quick cap, but I didn't have the time to adjust my, what you call it, access. So I'll do that next week. But that was part one. How about that?
I like that. I enjoyed that. That was a lot of information.
Mm-hmm. Part one. So we'll keep that. Part two will be the embroidery of the hat next week. How about that?
Sounds like
I'll
a plan
make sure
to me.
That I have a perfect design.
Yes.
And
we'll find
also,
something awesome.
Mm-hmm. Other than that, any questions, guys?
Mm-hmm. We're up to 11 people.
Mm-hmm. Any questions? Do you have any questions about the Tajima? Because if you do, I can answer that question for you as well.
Wait, give them a moment.
And thank you guys for always supporting us and all that good stuff.
All right, looks like it's quiet on the question front.
Okay.
So.
Can you follow me?
I can.
All right, I'm going to show something that is, I hadn't had a lot of time to promote yet, but I'll show you this.
Say hi to the people, Randy.
Hello, people.
Alright, so on the 4000, do you see that little
the green light? Yes.
Yeah.
You get all up in this machine's business here. That is awesome looking.
If you have a 4000, you can buy this attachment that goes onto the machine. And what that attachment allows you to do is you can then take and you can move this. So it's a cross beam. You can move it so that it's in the center of your foot. And I don't know why I don't have thread in my needle, but that's okay. But as you can see, you put it in the center of the foot. You see that?
Yeah.
All right. You can also move it so that it's over here on the side of the foot. So that you have certain seam allowances.
Yeah.
So it's up to you where you want to put that cross. Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
Yeah.
With Terry, that's quite the serious looking attachment.
Yeah. So if you don't want the attachment on it anymore, you just take it. There is an unlocking tool right here. And I haven't played with it a lot, but it unlocks it off of here. So this comes right off if you don't want it. But what's really cool is that it is an actual beam that will give you certain seam allowances so that you can use it wherever you want, that you can place the fabric edge right there. And then there's your quarter inch seam allowance. You see? Isn't that pretty cool?
In a little. That is really cool.
Isn't that pretty wild?
Yeah.
All right. So that is an available attachment, guys. So if you are interested in that, please give us a call at
757-588-1300.
And it's available for the, what you call it, the 4000 series only.
Okay.
But it is an attachment that can come off of your machine and go on your machine. It depends on what type of sewing you do. But when you're sitting here sewing, it's not interfering with my viewing area.
Yeah.
Okay? Because I'm sitting and sewing. But I love it because it is a beam that gives me a cross. I mean, a guidance. And then if I want it to be more in towards the needle, I can place it where the needle is. See? And then I know that this is my ditch.
Yeah.
So stitching in a ditch, guys, if you do a lot of stitching in a ditch, it's going to be wonderful. Do I have anything? Yeah, I do. Give me a quick moment. Stay right there. So let's stitch in a ditch, right? There we go. See?
Mm.
And so I can fine tune it where I want that beam to shine. And there is my green. Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
I likey, likey, likey.
I do too.
So it allows you, because you can, wherever you put that beam is where you're going to use as your guidance. See, between two whites, you can't really tell.
Yeah.
So that's why you can fine tune it. So it's pretty cool. And then when you don't want it, you just unplug it.
Yeah.
And take it right off the machine. What do you think?
That was cool.
Yes. So that is also available for the top of the line machine. Guys, we're going to call that a day.
Alright.
Ouch. That hurt. Alright, so.
Alrighty. Let me zoom us back out, because I've been zooming in. Pull us up a little, because we tall people. There we go.
Alright, guys. Guys, we're going to be back at 5 o'clock. We do have our first Zoom class. It is going to be the chenille polo.
That's at start of August?
I think
end of
it's
August?
At the end of August.
Somewhere in August.
So if you want to not come in, which we hate that, right? But if you're going to be at home and you want to zoom in and take a class, it's only $15. You register just like you do with a pay class in person. Just say Zoom in the notes.
Okay.
And then we will put you as a Zoom person. We will set the camera up and we will show you how to do it. I'm doing baby steps with Zoom classes because I don't want to.
We've got to figure out our bugs.
Well, we've got to figure out the bugs, but also too, Zoom is like, I think the longest you can do on a Zoom meeting is about 45 minutes at the moment.
Okay.
Unless we go into our advanced Zoom, and that is something we haven't done yet. So if you are wanting to take that class, go to our Facebook.
To the
FabricHut.com. FabricHut.com classes and pay for it per chenille polo, which is in there.
Yeah.
And just put Zoom and then that's it. That's all you do. We put you in the system and we'll get you you would get a confirmation email before the class starts, so you have that meeting link,
yeah.
Okay? If you've never done Zoom before, that's how it is. And that's how fun it is, okay? And what else? I think that's it, right?
Mm-hmm. Be back at 5. We've got shenanigans planned.
Yes, and we'll have something else up our sleeves, too. Until then, guys, thank you very much. Bye.